Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with a short overview about what's new in the Palette Manager. So let's open this in a new window and have it side by side. So let's open the Palette Manager with the Control Panel Appearance Palette, and then we can scroll down, make it a little bit bigger. Scroll down and show the editor, and as soon as the editor is shown, you can see there is a new icon here, because this is a cloned palette which can be deleted. And we can see here, this is the rocker theme. There has been some values changed, but changed in the shadow tiddler. So the recommendation, if you create a new let's create a new palette. So we switch to vanilla, and then here it says if you want to change something, then clone the palette, which we do. So we click the clone button here. It creates a new name, so this is new. Then it creates some new parameters, some metadata, and we can say save. And if a palette is open, there is an activate button. If I click it, then this palette is activated, as we can see here now. And yeah, that's basically it. What's new here? Make it a little bit bigger. If a palette is cloned, it contains a new origin field, so which links back to the original palette, and this makes it possible that we can have an undo button for every color that we change. So if I change it, make it a little bit lighter and make it green, then we can see, okay, it is changed, the color is changed, there is the color value, and we have the undo info. So if I switch palettes, if I switch to vanilla, then you can see it's yellow. If I switch to the new one, then it's green. So if we have a cloned palette, it's possible to have an undo for every value. If we change the theme itself, the shadow theme, then we only have the possibility to reset this palette and change all the values back to the default values. Okay, so there is a undo button for every color. Then there is a new search input here. For example, if I type in Aller, then I can see it searches for the color name, and then every element which is found shows the element, the color, and the preview, and the preview, and the preview, and so on. But as soon as there is the whole group, then it shows it like this. There is different colors with one preview. So it makes I think it makes it a little bit better. And it's the same thing if I click the set focus button here. So if I go to show everything and I set the focus, then it defines the search, and the search then lists fewer elements. Okay, so there is the search input and the focus button. As I said, we can go down, let's say everything which has a background in it. If we click focus, then it searches for all the elements, all the elements which have a background setting. Then what else is new? The editor now can handle the color macro, which is part of TillWiki. For example, if I go to the block quote bar here, then you can see now it directly shows the defined color, so it can handle BBB and it can handle the muted foreground color. If we go to TillWiki.com and if we open it here, appearance palette, and show the editor. And if we scroll down to the block quote bar, then you can see it cannot see any of them, because it has to be BBB. Yeah. So this can be shown by the default, and still it can't handle the color macro. Yeah. So now with the new palette manager, we have the possibility that this macro name is directly resolved. Yeah. And also, if I change it, if I set it to a different color, then you can see the second color is gone. But there is still the reset button. If I say reset, it uses the color muted foreground. Yeah. And if I change it here a little bit lighter, okay, then you can see those two colors are the same, and we have the undo button. Yeah. Okay, every element, or let's say element group, has a preview now. So these are some new titlers which are prefixed with palettes preview. Yeah, and then the name of the color where it should be shown. Yeah, in this case, alert muted foreground, and then it is shown after the alert muted foreground, and it also shows for the group. Yeah, as I showed you, if I say alert, yeah, then it shows it with every color element. Yeah, it should be easy to change. Yeah, as I did, just edit the titler, add some additional info that you need, some extra text, so you can easily change it. And if we go back to focus, then you can see there is some extra text, and here you have the link to the preview. Yeah, then as I said, you can also add new elements. For example, if you want to create one for alert highlight, you create this one and then name it alert highlight. So it should be easy to define your own elements. This is especially interesting for elements which are not part of the vanilla theme. So we can say show color names that are not part of the current palette, because there are some special elements which are defined with other palettes, for example base 0, base 00, and so on. And I don't have any previews for those elements. So yeah, this is open for the creators of those palettes that need special handling for different color names. Yeah, then there is also possibility some information about how to customize the preview. I showed you already that we have the prefix and color name, so you can define your new colors. Yeah, that's basically it. Did I miss something? I don't think so. Yeah. So with the new color palette, as soon as the editor is shown, we have some additional information. Here we can delete it, and we can reset palettes where we have overwritten the shadow titler. Then there is some dynamic info. Yeah. If you change the palette, then this text changes. This is already part of the existing palette, but now we have a little bit more information, and especially the new origin field, which allows us to do a single color undo. Yeah, that's basically it, and have fun!